standing by to share his story of hope. So, Mr. Gerald, welcome to CCFM and welcome to Breakfast with Friends. Thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Good morning. Thank you, Megan, for this opportunity.
Yeah, it's a pleasure.
And thank you for the listeners that is going to listen this morning about my life, where it actually started. So I'm trusting that this will bring hope for the hopeless. Mm-hmm. And that is it.
Fantastic. So let us know, Mr. Gerald, where did this all begin for you?
It takes me back many, many years. 1977, in October, when God spoke to me through His Word. And I've never actually came across the scripture. But one more evening, I had a visitation from God through somebody, a messenger, which is Pastor Duma. He was a Baptist minister of Durban. And he came to me in a vision, and he came to me and he shared with me the scripture, Isaiah 43, verse 1 to 8. He never told me this is in the Bible. He just sharing me with the scripture, reading it to me. And that was actually in the evening. And for me, it was just amazing that you could see trees, the greenness within the evening. And after that, he just went away. And then the very next morning when I woke up, I jumped to the Bible. And there, the same scripture, Isaiah 43, was there. And then I couldn't understand that, what is taking place within my life. And then I was working for a company, Diesel Electric, in Pardon Island in Cape Town. There were two brethren working there. One was a general cleaner. And that same month, October, he actually got this little booklet, which I've got in my hand. And the same scripture was on there. Then I said, well, I don't know what's taking place. And then I realized that this is the confirmation of God that He is speaking to me. And from that time, I had a desire really to serve the Lord. And I wasn't sure in which direction, but I had a desire really to bring change within our country, in our nation. And then I realized that God has called me into governance, to govern. That was the only time that people were speaking about politics. And to me, politics had a very bad connotation to me, because many things went wrong within our country. And I said, Lord, what must I do? And then I had an opportunity was given to me to become involved within politics. That was the only vehicle to get into bringing over the godly governance. And then in 1996, I took part within the first local democratic elections. And then I won my first elections, and that was under the Tigerberg municipal structures. And then I just had this desire to do greater things within my life. I saw that the only way you can be a Christian, but if you are not in a position of power where the power decisions are being made, then sometimes it can be tough. And I realized that you have to be in the position of power to make decisions. And since that time, I've been into godly governance. I believe that this country can only come right if we, everyone that professes to be a Christian, if we adhere to the principles of God and to apply that in our country today. So this morning, I'm here to encourage young people especially, that say that they don't get any job opportunities, they don't get any chances, business opportunities has been deprived from them. I can really say this morning, Don't give up. Put your trust in God. Do not put your trust in man. But if you put your trust in God, God will really come through for you. So this morning, I don't know what is the situation this morning. Perhaps you have been qualified for certain professions, or you've just done your matric. I want to encourage you this morning. If you know the Lord, God will really make a way for you. Just be steadfast. Just do what God wants you to do. People will give you advice. Yes, sometimes they give you good advice. Some will give you bad advice. But I can really say this morning, if you trust and obey, for there is no other way but to trust in Jesus, it is but to trust and to obey. Many a times I'm thinking of people that was in the Bible that God has been used. Joseph had a terrible time before he became the premier, but he actually stood still and he was just relying on God. I'm thinking of another person like Daniel. Daniel was accused of so many things, and even they tried to get Daniel hooked, where he was using the Bible, and the people actually tried to hook him on the very same Bible that he believed in, and the same God that he believed in. There was Moses, you know, also been through a terrible time, but God has been gracious unto him. God has been good to him. Now I'm comparing this. If you take 1977, and if you do your figures, then it is precisely about 41 years back that this has happened within my life. And today I can really say the Lord has been good to me. Although it was times where I thought, there is which way should I go? But God has been steadfast in his love. God has never changed. People has changed around me, but God has never changed. So this morning I can challenge any Christian young person out there. If you want to bring change within this country, let change start within your own life, so that people can see that God is true. God is the one that can bring change. Many of us, we are looking at various political parties, but that's only but promises. But if you put God first, then I can assure you that God will come through for us. And it is by time that we that professes to be Christians, that we should go back to the basics, that we should believe and become believing Christians again what God is saying to us. And I think it is by time that we should learn to listen to what is the Spirit of God saying unto us.
Gerald, just want to just ask you for your personal journey. There may be people listening and maybe they want to, you know, they want to have what you have, but maybe they just were never taught. They don't know how. They haven't grown in their relationship with God to a point where they can confidently say they know the voice of God. What was then that journey like for you, where you slowly but surely started to learn God's voice?
Yes, I've actually learned how God speaks to people. He speaks through his word. And God will always confirm some things within you. For instance, as I just mentioned to you, I didn't understand why should scripture come to you three times or two times. Or some people will speak within to your life, and then people will speak and they will tell you things, and they will tell it on various occasions to you. That is when God is speaking to you. God speaks in various ways, but I've learned when God speaks, then he will confirm things within your life.
How important is it in your journey, have you noticed, Gerald? How important is it to actually follow on with what the voice of God is saying to you, you know, to actually go and apply and be obedient in a sense to that voice. How important, how vital is that in this journey?
It's very important to be obedient, because the Bible teaches us obedience is the way to your success. You know, when God tells you to go to a certain person, doubt will come in. But you just have to realize what is God telling you. What is God saying to you? Sometimes, you know, when you speak with somebody and say, God has spoken to you, then say, oh, did God speak to you? How did God speak to you? But God will confirm things with you in your life. And that is a confirmation. And if you do get the confirmation, then you can know that God is behind what he is trying or saying to you.
Sure. Gerald, thank you so much for encouraging us this morning, really, with your testimony and what God has been doing in your life. Would you mind ending off with just a short prayer? Because I know there are people, like the questions that I've been asking you, who are listening and they admire your relationship, but they just maybe feel that they're not there just yet with God. Would you please pray just for those people and that eyes and hearts would be open this morning?
Thank you for this opportunity to pray for these people this morning. Father God, we thank you this morning for your mercies. Your mercies endureth forever, my God. Father, thank you, my God, for what you have done within my life. Lord, you can do it in the lives of other people. And this morning I pray, O God, especially for our young people, our older folks, O Lord, those who are going through various trials and temptations. Lord, I pray this morning that you will intervene, that you will intercede, and you will bring change where there needs to be change within the lives of people. Mm-hmm. Father, you, God, you are a changing God. You change lives, O Lord. And whenever you change somebody's lives, O Lord, it will benefit you. Lord, we need you, O God, to come and do great things within our nations. Mm-hmm. And Lord, whenever there is young people this morning, they don't know where to go. The best place that they can go, it's to go to God. Your word declares, O God, come unto me. Whoever are heavy laden and burdened,
yeah,
come to me and I will give you rest. And this morning, Lord, we are privileged that we can find rest in Jesus. Rest in God. Peace in God. Lord, we pray this morning that you will undertake in every situation and bring change and hope within this nation. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Gerald R. Siljeur, thank you so much for your story this morning.
Thank you.
God bless you.
Thank you.